गुड मॉर्निंग, वेलकम टू टुडे सेशन। यस्टरडे आई हैव एक्सप्लेन अबाउट सीरीज पार्ट प्रोग्राम एंड मेथड्स ऑफ पार्ट प्रोग्रामिंग एंड बेसिक्स ऑफ सीरीज प्रोग्राम प्रोसीजर। इन दैट वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द एनसी कोऑर्डिनेट सिस्टम एंड फ्लोटिंग डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ मेजर सिस्टम, फ्लोटिंग जीरो एंड फिक्स्ड जीरो, डिफरेंस बिटवीन फ्लोटिंग जीरो एंड फिक्स्ड जीरो। So, machining is achieved by digging the tool into the workpiece and causing relative motion between the workpiece and the tool. For some machines, the tool undergoes the primary motion, whereas some other, the workpiece undergoes the primary motion. When writing an CNC part program, it is always assumed that it is the tool that undergoes the primary motion. Thus, the part program does not have to remember which element moves for which machine, and it is easier for the programmer to visualize the motion of the tool related to the workpiece during the programming stage. If it is indeed the tool that moves related to the workpiece, such as in turning operations, the motions programmed are the motions that actually take place. If it is the workpiece that moves related to the tool, such as in the case of milling, the programmed motions have to be translated internally by the system to cause the workpiece to move in such a way as to achieve the equivalent relative motion that was programmed for the tool. So, and NC part program includes, among other things, commands that move the tool to various locations related to the workpiece. To be able to specify the required tool positions, some reference point is required, and this reference point used within the program as the basis of defining the tool location and other geometry entities is referred to as the origin. So, discuss about the part programming. The part program is a sequence of instructions which describe the work which has to be done on a part in the form of required by a computer under the control of a numerical control computer program. And we require some machining data for writing this program, as like machining sequence, classification of process, tool startup point, cutting depth, tool path, etc. And cutting conditions like spindle speed, feed rate, coolant, etc., and selection of the cutting tool. And while preparing the part program, we need to perform the following steps. So, determine the startup procedure and select the tool and determine the tool offset. Set up the zero position for the workpiece and select the speed and rotation of the spindle. Set up the tool motions according to the profile required, and end the program by stopping the spindle and coolant. So methods of part programming are manual part programming and computer aided part programming. So the process of generating the part programs manually by a part programmer is known as manual part programming. And this technique is widely used for pieces of simple geometry. And to prepare a part program using manual method, the programmer writes machining instructions on a special form called manuscript. The manuscript is a listing of relative tool and workpiece locations. It also includes other data such as preparatory commands, miscellaneous functions, and speed and feed specifications. There will be written This will be written by the part programmer in a coded form called program manuscript. This would be punched on a paper tape, and the tape will be fed into the tape reader of the machine controller. I will prepare the tape with the help of a flexorator. The next one, computer-aided part programming. In computer-aided part programming, geometry of elements of the component is defined using a simple abbreviated English-like terms. This is known as computer-aided part programming. There are a large number of part programming languages. APT automatically programmer tools, ADAPT AutoSpot, compared to 2CL and Split. And in the MC coordinate system, so as I said, part program is a series of coded instructions for affecting the various machine functions necessary to make a specific part on a particular machine tool. Among the most important of these functions is maintaining the correct tool workpiece positional relationship during the machining. This is achieved by establishing a coordinate system and then defining tool workpiece motion in terms of the coordinate system. So in this, we'll define X, Y, and Z axis. So first, Z axis, this is the most important axis for machining, and it is always aligned with the spindle that imparts cutting power. The spindle might rotate the workpiece as in a lathe, or it might rotate a tool as in the case of a milling machine. So next I discussed about x-axis. The x-axis is the principal axis of motion in which the moving element such as tool or workpiece is positioned. It is parallel to the work holding surface and is arranged to be horizontal if possible. And the y-axis, once the z and x-axis are established, the y-axis must be in such a way in such a direction as to complete a right-handed Cartesian coordinate system. So these are the axes, X, Y, and Z axis, and in this AB and C are rotational axes about X and Y, Z axis respectively. These are rotational axes A, B, and C. And I discussed about the floating zero versus fixed zero. The purpose of the coordinate system is to provide a means of locating the tool in relation to the workpiece. Depending on the type of NC machine, the part programmer may have several options for specifying the location. One of these options depend on whether the machine has a fixed zero or a floating zero. In the case of a fixed zero, the origin is always located at the same position on the machine table. And the second method is floating zero method. In these NC machines, allows the machine operator to set the zero point at any position on the machine table. In the latter, we discussed about the absolute coordinate system and incremental coordinate system. So in the absolute coordinate system, the desired target position of the tool for a particular move is given related to the origin of the program. Next one, incremental coordinate system. In this mode, the next target position for the tool is given related to the current tool position. So this is about the absolute coordinate system and incremental coordinate system. And we discussed about the structure of the NC part program. In this We discussed about the fixed sequential format, tab sequential format, and what address format. And the objectives of today's session are, in this we are going to discuss about the identifying part programming methods, familiarize with the what address format, and familiarize with the G codes or preparatory functions and miscellaneous functions or M codes. So this is the purpose of the various alphabetic codes in the what address format. So like N is used to indicate the block number, G is used for preparatory function, X it derives in X direction, Y in Y direction, Z in Z direction, R is clearance plane, IJK arc centers for X, Y, Z in directions respectively, F is for feed rate, T represents the tool number. Likewise, M represents the miscellaneous function. Q it represents the subroutine. So these are the various words we use in what address format to write the NC part program. Now before going to start, I'll explain about the fundamentals of NC part programming. The first step in writing an NC part program is to determine and organize the data that will be used within the program. NC programmer has to carry out process planning functions such as selecting specific machining processes to use in making the part, the associated cutting speeds and feeds, and the cutting tools to use, and so on. For simple components, these decisions can be made mentally and the program coded directly. For more complicated parts, however, it is preferable to organize the data systematically in a formal process plan. And this plan will list in a proper sequence all the individual operations that have to be carried out to make the part, the work holding devices needed, and the tools to be used. The programmer will also need to decide whether to use coolant during the machining process and such other details related to each operation. A fully coded NC part program generally consists of 5 broad categories or classes of commands. These are listed below in no particular order, like so. And use of the word address format is assumed in this. So we will use preparatory functions, axis motion commands, feed and speed commands, identification commands, and miscellaneous commands. So in this G is for preparatory function and M is for miscellaneous functions. And the calculations involved in cutter plane definition, tool compensation, etc. also involved in this one. So here we are going to discuss about the what address format to write our NC part programs. And this is the structure of the NC what address format. So this is an example for what address format. So for example, N40, Z00, X0, Y0 and Z300. N is the sequence number, G is the preparatory command, here Z00 for rapid movement, and XYZ. X, Y, Z are relative or absolute coordinate of the cutter. So first round preparatory functions are G codes. Preparatory functions form the largest class of commands used in C programs. They are identified by the word address letter capital G followed by the digits. So like this, capital G followed by the digits. The digits specify the particular type of function. Here Z01 means it interpolation. So next, the combination is referred to as G code, like G01, G00, G02, G03, etc. In general, preparatory functions have the effect of making the MCU assume specific operating conditions or command the controller to perform the next task in a particular manner. Preparatory functions generally take effect before execution of the other commands within the block in which the function is programmed. It is usually permissible to program more than one preparatory word in a block provided the words do not have conflicting effects. Most preparatory functions are modal. Efforts have been made to standardize NC commands. So like Z00, Z01, Z02, Z03, so Z90, Z91, etc. So these are the widely used standard G codes. And all codes are available, not all codes are available on all machines, and also that a manufacturer may give a particular code a meaning other than the standard meaning. And always check the manual to verify the meaning of a particular code on a specific controller. So this is about the preparatory functions. Let me explain about it once again. These form the largest class of commands used in NC programs. They are identified by the word address letter G followed by the digits. The digits specify the particular type of function. Say for example, Z00, it indicates the rapid movement. Z01, it indicates the linear interpolation. In general, preparatory functions have the effect of making the MCU assume specific operating conditions or command the controller to perform the next task in a particular manner. So some of the G codes are G00, G01, G02, G03, G04, G71, G70, G90 and G91, etc. So this is some preparatory functions. For example, G00 is for rapid movement. Z00 is a preparatory function to specify that the tool should be moved to a specified location. This function is used only to control the final position of the tool and is not concerned with the path that is followed in arriving at the final destination. For this reason, motion with this function is also referred to as positioning mode. The way this code is implemented in most controllers is that all axes that need to be moved in order to get to the target point are moved simultaneously at the beginning of the motion. With each axis being moved at maximum speed. So, for example, here the tool location is another place. And we want the tool to be at position 0,0. So for that, we will use Z00 command. So next one, Z01, it interprets the linear interpolation. It is another preparatory function used to specify that the tool should be moved to a specified location. And it differs from the Z00 function in that the path followed by the tool in moving to the target point is required to be the straight line connecting the current tool position and the target position. Thus, the path followed by the tool is in effect specified by the programmer. Because this function is always causes the tool to follow a linear path between the two points, it is also referred to as linear interpolation. If motion in more than one axis is involved, MCU coordinates the simultaneous motions in the axis to generate a straight line path. The rate of travel during the motion is specified by the programmer, giving like a feed speed, a feed rate value. This function Z01 is typically used to specify machining of straight features such as turning a chamfer on a lathe or cutting a slot on a milling machine. Next one, Z02. It is also a preparatory function used to specify the tool should be moved to a specified location. It differs from Z00 and Z0 function in that in this case the path followed by the tool in moving to the target point is required to be a circular arc. Starting from the current tool position, moving in a clockwise direction and ending at the target position. Within the block in which the Z02 code is programmed, the center of the arc is given by specifying its location related to the start of the arc. And we will use the combinations of I, J and K words depending on the plane in which the motion occurs. These are used to specify the location of the center of the arc related to the start of the arc. Thus, the path followed by the tool is again specified by the programmer. This type of motion is referred to as circular interpolation. Z02 is circular interpolation. In this case, motion in more than one axis is always involved, and MCU coordinates the simultaneous motions to generate the circular path. On most machines, circular interpolation can be carried out within only one of three possible planes at a time. The available planes are XY, ZX and YZ. And usually XY plane is assumed if a plane is not explicitly specified. And the codes Z17 and Z19 are used to select the plane of operation. So this is about the Z02. Z03, it is also circular interpolation similar to Z02, except that all motion occur in a counterclockwise direction. So let me explain about the Z00 code once again. It is a preparatory function to specify that the tool should be moved to a specified location. This location is used only to control the final position of the tool and is not concerned with the path that is followed in arriving at the final destination. For this reason, motion with this function is also referred to as positioning mode. The way this code is implemented in most controllers is that all axes that need to be moved in order to get to the target point are moved simultaneously at the beginning of the motion, with each axis being moved at a maximum speed. So 001, it is used to specify that the tool should be moved to a specified location. It differs from 000 function in that the path followed by the tool in moving to the target point is required to be straight line connecting the current tool position and the target position. Thus, the path followed by the tool is in effect specified by the programmer. And this Z01 function is also called as linear interpolation. If the motion in more than one axis is involved, the MC coordinates the simultaneous motions in the axis to generate a straight line path. G02, it is also called as circular interpolation. It is different from Z00 and Z01 functions in that, in this case, the path followed by the tool in moving to the target point is required to be a circular arc, starting from the current tool position, moving in a clockwise direction, and ending at the target position. So in this, we need to specify the center of the arc, and we will use I, J, K words used to specify the location of the center of the arc related to the start position of the arc. Thus, the path followed by the tool is again specified by the programmer. This type of motion is referred to as circular interpolation. G03, it is also circular interpolation similar to G02, except that all motion occurs in a counterclockwise direction. And the next code is Z70. By this, we are saying controller to accept units in inches. So all the dimensions will be in inches in this G70 code. G71, it is used for metric units. Controller accepts metric units in this G71 code. If we specify G71. And the G90 for absolute dimensioning method. And by this we are saying to the controller that use absolute positioning system. G91, it is for incremental system. So if we use G91, controller will use incremental system. These are some other G codes. Like we will use Cannot cycles. These are some sequence of machining operations are used to used so frequently with different machines and different components that have been standardized and assigned special preparatory function. For example, a simple hole drilling operation involves following the sequence. First one, position the tool just above the point where the hole is to be drilled. Second one, set the correct spindle speed. Third one, feed the tool into the workpiece at a controlled feed rate to a predetermined depth. Fourth one, retract the tool at a rapid rate to just above the point where the hole started. And the same sequence of operations is repeated for any simple drilling operations regardless of the machine used. So some Cannot cycle functions are GAT1 for drilling, GAT2, GAT3, GAT4, GAT5, GAT6, GAT7, GAT8 and GAT9. So these are some Cannot cycle in preparatory function. Next one, miscellaneous functions and imports. Miscellaneous functions are used to control a variety of machine functions that are not covered by the other commands like G code, F code, T code, etc. The address for a word M followed by digits is used to specify miscellaneous commands like M01, M02, etc. Examples of functions controlled by miscellaneous commands are turning the spindle on and off, turning coolant on and off, initiating a tool change, clamping and unclamping the workpiece, interrupting and restarting the program execution, stopping the program and rewinding the program. Generally, miscellaneous commands take effect after execution of the other commands in the block in which they are programmed. It is usually permissible to program more than one miscellaneous commands in a given block, provided they do not have conflicting effects. Many of the M codes have been assigned standardized functions. However, some available codes have not been assigned specific meaning. Some of the more commonly used M codes are M02, it indicates the program stop. M03, spindle rotates in clockwise direction. M04, spindle rotation counterclockwise direction. M05, spindle off. M06 is used for changing the tool. M08 for coolant. For coolant on in flood. M09, coolant off. So M98 for calling for the subroutine, and these are the some other M codes. And along with these G and M codes, we'll also use axis motion commands. Axis motion commands are used to specify the axis that are required to move during the execution of a given command. They are made up of letters specifying an axis such as X followed by dimensional information associated with the motion of the axis. Let me show you that. So this is X, Y, Z, I, Z, K, etc. in this. Like in this, we'll specify as X20, Z-30, so like this. The X, Y and Z commands respectively specify motion of the Cartesian coordinate axis themselves, and IJK specify offset values related to the X, Y and Z axis respectively, while A, B and C specify rotation about X, Y and Z axis. Some controllers support the use of polar coordinates in which case R and A-axis are used to specify the radial and angular directions. And these dimensional data associated with an axis command can represent absolute dimensions if G90 is used, and incremental mode if G91 is specified. And most control systems require that I, J and K data used in specifying circular interpolation be given as incremental values regardless of whether G90 or G91 is in effect elsewhere in the program. The dimensional data associated with the axis commands consist of real numbers that may or may not have a sign associated with them. The actual format for the data is given as part of the specification of the controller. And axis motion, axis command guides the motion of the point defining the tool position. For some operations such as profile milling, the periphery of the cutter moves along the surface to be machined rather than the tool point. Thus, actual motion of the tool point has to be along the path different from the geometry of the machine surface. This difference is called tool offset, and the programmer has to account for it. So, for when writing the part program, most modern controllers can be programmed using an offset tool by applying a compensating factor called cutter compensation. So, this is about the axis motion commands. These are used to specify the axes that are required to move during the execution of a given command. They are made up of a letter specifying an axis such as X, followed by the dimensional information associated with the motion of the axis. So, like we use X, Y, Z, I, J, K, and for rotational moment, we'll use A, B, and C. Next commands we use are feed and speed commands. These are F word and S word. Feed and speed commands are used to specify the feed rate and speed to use during the machining operation. The feed command is specified by the address word F followed by the numerical value of the feed rate required. So, like F220, like this. The speed command is specified by the address word S followed by the required speed. So this this will be represented as S followed by 200 like this. The feed rate and speed used during the machining are of crucial importance in determining how long it will take to make a part. Therefore, they play a key role in the overall economics and productivity of the process. Choosing very low values will result in large processing times, low productivity, poor quality, and an uneconomical product. Choosing excessively large values can result in broken tools, damaged workpieces, a high scrap rate, and again uneconomical products. And one of the skills required of the NC programmer is the ability to select optimum cutting conditions given the constraints inherent in the production process. And the units for cutting conditions can be specified in a variety of ways in NC program. For example, feed rate may be specified directly in units per minute or units per revolution, where the units may be in inches or millimeters. And the cutting speed may be specified in spindle revolutions per minute or directly as a surface cutting speed, feet per minute or meter per minute. And the preparatory functions Z92, Z98 are used to designate how the cutting conditions are to be specified. So these are the feed and speed commands. And next one, invert. This is used to identify the sequence number. Invert is the most widely used identification command, and it is used to identify individual block within the program. Usually 3 or 4 digits are used, and leading or trailing zeros are not suppressed in inverts. So this is about the inverts. And some special character also we will use in NC part program. And in addition to the commands discussed above, certain special characters are used in NC part programs to achieve special effects. Some of these special characters are used with all controllers, but others are particular to specific controllers. These include the percent sign, like this sign, percent. Common to all controllers, which is used as the first line of NC program. The character signals the controller when the beginning of the program has been reached during a rewind of the program, so that it will stop rewinding. Due to separate successive blocks within the program, an end of block character is used at the end of each block of the program. This special character is produced by hitting a carriage return on a keyboard. The character itself does not print when the program is printed during the coding. The end of block is frequently represented by the symbol or by using the letters EOB, end of block. Another special character is the backslash character, which indicates commands that may optionally be skipped during the program execution. And other special characters that are sometimes used . So these are the some other special characters we will use in the program, which are related to characterizing special controller capabilities, such as defining the loops and macros. So this is about the special characters used in NC part program. So let me tell you once again. First one, this one, percent sign. It is common to all controllers, which is used as the first line of the NC program. And these two used to indicate the end of the block. And these are some other special characters we will use in NC part programs related to characterizing special controller capabilities, such as defining the loops and macros. So today we discussed about the word address format and different kind of words used in the address format, like M, N, G, F, S, T, and T is used to indicate the two number. So like this, T followed by the number, so it represents the tool number 1. And I have explained about the preparatory functions, G codes, and some of the G codes like G00, G01, G02, and G03. And I have explained about miscellaneous functions, M codes, and I showed you some M codes like the M00, M01, M02, M03, M04. M07, M08, M09, and M30 and M98, etc. And I have explained about axis motion commands, and explained about feed and speed commands, and some of the identification commands, and I explained about some of the special characters used in NCI part program. Thank you.